Brofist to you all, as once again I have bestowed the glorious lore upon you. You can thank me later. You can thank me later for gifting you the knowledge that I have been imparted with within my cranium and spreading it onto you people so that we can all rejoice in the stories and the magnificence of the Warcraft lore. Broxagar, the Lich King, until Sylvanas came and took away his little helmet thing. What a bummer. And it's all happening. It's all happening right here, right now. That's what's going on. Stay tuned for more news as it happens. I hope you've had a fantastic week. It's been super busy, super interesting with Blizzard careering towards the release of the Shadowlands and, of course, the pre-patch coming, which means I have been balls deep polishing up all your UI needs. Retesting them after the Legos are going to be changed and do all that kind of stuff. So it's a fun night for me, buried in my office, getting that fixed. But we should have it out for you over the weekend, which means you can mess around with it and alter it and do all those kinds of wonderful things as pre-patch does arrive. So it's going to be good. But remember, if you do, I just want to put this out there because so many people are going to get this wrong. If you do install the Shadowlands UI before the pre-patch comes, it's likely not to work. Okay, so if you are going to test it or change stuff, do it on the PTR. Don't do it on retail until the pre-patch, because that's when all the like code changes, all right? Like, don't install it on retail WoW and be like, it's not working, don't fucking work, there's WoW shit. Dumb you, mate. Like, it's... we use different add-ons in the Shadowlands that are for Shadowlands, and we don't have Shadowlands yet. So, like, don't do that. Don't book in... Don't tweet me. That's all I'm saying is don't fucking work this. There's loads of shit in here that's not even in the game. The fuck is a soulbind? What's this fucking weak aura, mate? Like, don't do that to me, all right? Don't do that to me. But it will have everything in there from all the soulbind stuff, no matter what you pick, all your legendaries that are currently in the game. Of course, updates will be required. On top of that, I have giveaways to do, so it'll probably be a weekend stream. I have all this cool stuff to give away. This is the press kit that Blizzard have sent me for the Shadowlands, which is actually awesome. I actually don't want to reopen it again because it's in pristine condition. But in here is all sorts of very cool collector's items, like holograms for all the covenants, like an in-game guide. This is actually the official press kit thing, and so I want to give that away to you guys. And Blizzard have saw fit, considering the Shadowlands has been delayed, to bless me with yet more beta keys. And this time, it's actually keys. They're giving us keys. It's not a case of get your battle nets and all that nonsense. I actually straight up just have beta keys to hand out to you guys to help with testing. And this is a good thing, because if you've been paying attention to our YouTube content recently, they are desperate for fresh blood on the beta, because a lot of people who've been testing the beta and the alpha for months and months cannot be fucked anymore. I wish I was lying, but they really cannot be fucked anymore. They have had all the goodwill and the good testing drained from them, like Aventhia attacking them in the night, and they are definitely not into doing that much testing anymore. So they are really hoping to get a lot more of you into the beta so you can actually test and get stuff done. So I have a number of beta keys to give away. We'll probably do that tomorrow sometime. I feel like I had something happening. So we do have some things happening with the Shadowlands launch delayed. It doesn't actually make an effect, but we do have a Halloween special coming up for those of you who are on Twitch, which will be me and Nobble in cosplay, and we'll be playing the Dark Prophecy trilogy, the brand new trilogy. It's the one game out of the trilogy. We've played the other two, but the latest game comes out and we're going to do some cosplay and have some Halloween stuff going on and all sorts of cool stuff like that. Yet, it might be a little quiet here because right now I have approximately 480 quid's worth of stuff sat in my office that is for one video. Because I got inspired. So I currently have boxes and boxes of stuff in my office because I felt like making a really fun, silly video. So we have all kinds of stuff. It should be fun, and it should be coming out for you on Halloween. It's all good. It's all good. The last thing I want to say, this is sellout stuff, I know, but considering we don't have many left, because Emma tweeted out that there were few remaining and many of you got in contact, if you do want one of the original Preach Gaming mouse mats, the big ones, there's not many left at all because everybody wants them before they officially go on sale. So Emma has been announcing that. So if you do want them, please contact Emma on Twitter just in case, because there's very, very few of them left. They're supposed to be being sold on our new website, which launches later in the month, but people were desperate for them. So there you go. Speak to Emma on Twitter. I think it's misspreach@twitter.com or whatever it is, to get in contact with her. So if anybody in the mods or whatever can just let people know what her Twitter is. If you do want one before they kind of disappear, let us know. The new design is coming. We won't be making any more of these. All right, then. I think that's everything. We're not going to talk about conduits because that's too dramatic. I'm going to make you sad. I'm going to make you a little sad in a weird, weird way. I'm going to make you very, very sad. Brave. This is the wrong keyboard. Let me get my secondary keyboard. There we go. Brave. Sir Finley. Brave Sir Finley. Oh, the tales we shall weave of brave Sir Finley and his journey to being a hero. Oh, brave Sir Finley. He'll be fine. He's called Finley, not Fingal. It's all good. All right, so we need Tobias. And we need a happy stoner guy. Nicola. Nicola could be happy stoner guy. And we need a friend. Who could be a friend? Oh, Dave. Classic name. Dave. Dave the friend. Friend Dave. Friend Dave will keep us in touch, I'm pretty sure. This better not ruin your rep. No. I'm sure you're absolutely fine, Finn. I wouldn't worry about it. Okay. Are you ready? Bear with me on this one. We're going down a weird road. Oh, it's drama time, baby. This is my story. This is my adventure. And this is how it all ended. Let me explain myself. I started my World of Warcraft journey when the Burning Crusade was out, but I could not reach that level 70 until near the end of the expansion, for I was 12 years of age. And I found an online article. It was about how people were making money off World of Warcraft selling gold and characters. I had heard of WoW, but I just thought it was a game for massive, spotty nerds. I never thought of playing it, because I was cool. I was playing cool games, like Grand Theft Auto. I owned the coolest of consoles, the PlayStation 2. I had recently managed to get Grand Theft Auto San Andreas, and therefore, I was giga cool. I never did any of the missions. I would just wander around, blowing shit up. Maximum swagger. So about back to World of Warcraft then. I was 12. I had no pennies. So when I read I could make actual cash from playing a nerd game, I was pretty excited. Maybe WoW is lame, but at the end of the day, it's a game and I'm going to make some big money. So I went to the web and did my research and saw you can have a free trial. Perfect. Can check out my master plan. I installed the game and launched it for the first time. Immediately picked a night elf, but I struggled at choosing the class. Don't we all? I love animals and hunters have pets, but druids can turn into animals. What a conflict. It was a hard choice. In the end, I went for hunter after thinking about it long and hard. A night elf hunter. Okay. A 12-year-old picking a night elf hunter is not a long, hard decision at all, you little Legolas. We know what happened. All right. Who are you talking to? We know what happened. This is because you got abused for being a fucking Legolas. And you were like, nah, mate. Like, it's because I've got this affinity for animals and that. And I was like, I was at the character creation screen for like 3 hours. And I was like, I could be a druid, like, but yeah, okay. Mm-hmm. We get you. In the hunter, I logged into the game for the first time, and I am blown away by the beauty of Teldrassil. Yikes. I will never forget the awe I felt exploring Teldrassil for the first time. Fox Sylvanas. One of the first things I noticed was that I had no pet. What lies I had been told. I did a few quests and got a few levels, but I struggled and mobs were killing me. Surely, my lack of pets was the problem. To the web I go. And I read that you do not get a pet until level 10. This is going to be tough, I thought to myself, but I can do this. When I reached level 10, I went to my hunter trainer, but there was no spell there to have a pet. I was confused. And I only did one quest at a time, so I didn't pick up the quest that he had for me, because I had yet to complete my previous quest. Big thinker. I had seen a hunter with a pet, so I knew. This was possible. It was possible. I couldn't be bothered to go back to the web as I'd have to close the game down again. And it would take me ages to open WoW again. Yeah. Instead, I did the quest to go to the Night Elf capital, Darnassus. I remember the epic music playing as I entered the city. He's 12, man. He doesn't know Alt-Tab yet, all right? He doesn't know. He hasn't yet figured out the quickest way to hide the pawn, all right? He's 12, all right? He doesn't have the reflexes you guys have got, okay? He doesn't have that yet. That's Twitch-level gameplay, all right? That's Twitch muscle memory, and he doesn't have it yet. I remember the epic music playing as I entered the city. As I'm walking through, something catches my eye. An owl vendor. This is how I would get my pet. I was going to be exactly like Harry Potter. Awesome. Thumbs fresh. It makes sense now. I saw someone with an owl not long ago. I went to this vendor and clicked. There was a choice of 3 different owls. There was a catch, though. 50 silvery coins. I don't have 50 silvery coins. A plan. I won't buy any more spells, and eventually the owl will be mine. Questing was tedious. I'm getting frustrated. Eventually, whilst running for my life from a bunch of mobs, I fell off of Teldrassil, and I died. I could not get back to my corpse. And that was the end of my Night Elf Hunter. Of course, I went for my second choice this time, Druid. And I have been a Druid ever since. I begged my mother, buy me this game. Bestow it upon me, mother. I told her the brilliant idea I had about making money. And she bought it and got me the game while giving me that look. Mm-hmm. I grew up with WoW. My journey with WoW had its fair share of newbie moments, for sure. I wasn't a total noob, though. Hard to believe. I moved using my mouse from the very beginning. Wow. Ooh, fancy. The catch was, though, I was a clicker. I would move my character to where I needed her to be, click my abilities. I could not possibly move and use abilities at the same time. As you can imagine, I was pretty shit. I did get the hack of using keybindings eventually. Oh, you don't even keybind. You don't even use the keyboard for moving your character, even when you're clicking. You use the mouse for both your abilities and moving. And what was your first line of this paragraph? I wasn't a complete noob, though. The talent tree was confusing. I didn't realize there was more than one until I had quite a bit. So my first few talents were all in the balance tree. And then I decided to mix things up and go into feral. I can't remember when I fixed this, but it was quite some time after I had hit level 70. I couldn't afford to waste money respecking like an idiot. One thing that frustrated me about World of Warcraft is that you had all of these abilities and not enough room on the one action bar. And scrolling through the action bars to find the ability you needed was a real pain. Is it? I've never tried it. Like, never. I genuinely remember feeling so angry that they would make the game this way. I played in Method with a fantastic player called Protek, considered one of the best paladins in the world, who did use scrolling action bars. And when I asked him about it, he said it just the way he'd learned to play. And it just blew my fucking mind. It blew my fucking mind. Sloot uses it. It like kills my soul when I see it. It kills my soul. It's like healers who click the frames. You know who you are. You have to like click before you press the healing spell. Click, press. Click, press. Click, press. Like, what in the titty fucking god are you doing? Jesus Christ. Ooh, baby. Oh, I know you're out there and I know you're watching. I know you're watching. You want to change that shit. All right. Well, 50% less inputs. Sounds good to me. Right? Right? 50% less inputs. Pretty good. Just half as many. Nice. Much more efficient. My God, imagine. Imagine. I remember that this action bar scrolling frustration really, really got to me. So I explained to someone in game as he complained. The thing was, he didn't understand what on earth I was talking about. So he had me add him to MSN so I could send him a screenshot of what was bothering me. It was then that I learned that you can have multiple action bars. And that made things much easier. During the beginning stages of WoW, I made many friends, but as I grew older, my anxiety started to grow. It became a struggle when I started to become scared of doing content with other players, especially if I didn't know them. Over the years, the friends I made either stopped playing or we gradually lost touch over time. I only really had one friend now that I am close with in WoW, and his name is Tobias. Tobias is a protection paladin, and I used to think he was the god of World of Warcraft. And you know why? During Wrath of the Lich King, Tobias was a raider. Can you imagine? I thought only the most elite WoW players could call themselves raider. He would tell me of his raid career, but it was short-lived because he had a potato PC and the lag made the more difficult encounters impossible, and would sometimes just crash his PC. But to this day, he still boasts about his time in Naxxramas, Wrath of the Lich King. He was the only one this one time to get through the Hygen Dance. It was his crowning moment of World of Warcraft. Eventually, his PC couldn't run World of Warcraft at all, and he stopped playing. And Tobias never came back. For the most part of my World of Warcraft, though, I've been a solo player. I never did any content that wasn't solo. I mostly did old raids and dungeons for rare mounts, collecting pets and whatnot. I started to get into the lore of WoW and read the books. I even took breaks from World of Warcraft and played other RPGs and fell in love. If my 12-year-old self could see me now, she'd think I was a giga nerd. Then Legion. The green fire fell from the sky, and I saw a familiar person come back online. It was Tobias. After all these years, he had gotten himself a new computer, and that meant returning to the World of Warcraft. He so quickly joined a guild and started raiding again. He starts asking me to do dungeons and stuff with him. I never did anything mental like mythic keys. Aww. Jesus Christ. Mental. Mythic keys? Are you fucking high, mate? You are out of your tree, mate. Mythic plus on that. As you can imagine, I had a lot to learn, having avoided group content for most of World of Warcraft. But I found I really enjoyed healing more than DPS, and I started to improve. I even started to do what I considered the beginning of raiding. LFR. You were scared of LFR? Oh, come on. Don't like it. I became somewhat competent and started to identify that most people in an LFR group either didn't care or had no idea what they were supposed to be doing. It's now time for our detour. It's time that I introduce you, ladies and gentlemen, to Sir Finley. Sir Finley is a fish. A Siamese fighting fish. He is known for their vivid colours and flowing fins. Sir Finley was different, though. He was dull, not brightly coloured. His fins had been shredded, and he looked very, very sad. I instantly felt a connection with him. I think my druidic and healing nature compelled me to help this poor, poor creature. In the shop, Sir Finley was a lot cheaper than the other better fish. And I asked the pet shop owner, what is the story of Sir Finley? Sir Finley had been given to the shop by his old owner because his other fish in his tank had bullied him. They'd attacked him. They had hurt Sir Finley. Poor, poor Sir Finley, I thought. He deserves a home. He's just a fish. So amongst all those conventionally beautiful, beautiful betterfish, I chose Sir Finley. To me, he was the most beautiful of all of them in the shop. And what an amazing fish he was. His fins, they healed. And although they were never long or flowing like other fish, they were beautiful to me. His colour changed from a dull grey to a brilliant white, and he glowed like the light of a loon. The best thing about him, though, was Mr. Finley, his personality. Sir Finley was smart. He recognized me and would get excited when he saw me in anticipation of food. Best of all, Sir Finley knew tricks. Yes, the fish knew tricks. I target trained him and taught him to swim through a hoop. When I felt down, stressed or anxious, watching Sir Finley swimming around in his tank with such grace and serenity would calm me, relax me, make me feel calm. Then came Battle for Azeroth. Back to World of Warcraft, a BFA is coming around. I've started to feel more confident in myself. I want to raid. I am becoming a raider. But LFR, no. At least normal raiding. Big stuff. I talked to Tobias. Do you think I've got what it takes? He says his guild could always use a healer. Join us. Sign up. Become a raider. The guild master's name was Nicola. Seemed like a nice guy at first. The guild was a heroic guild that would manage a few mythic bosses and raided 4 days a week. We're on a dead server, so all the good players are in the big boy guilds. And the rejects would be in all the other guilds. Like mine. My first night, I was nervous. But it was everyone's first time here, and overall we had a great laid-back time and cleared some bosses. One of the raiders was a complete stoner called Dave, who was most laid back, too laid back, and honestly, he fucked up all the time. But you know what? Dave was funny. Really funny. He was kind of like the guild mascot. As we started progressing in heroic and getting stuck on bosses, I noticed Nicola quite easily started to lose patience. Started to get harsh when people made mistakes. Nicola would lose his temper and call people dumb fucking idiots and things like that for just the tiniest of little errors. It raised my anxiety, but I was always in communication with Tobias, who would calm me down. Say, don't worry about it. He doesn't mean it. It's a spur of the moment thing. He's not good with his anger. In Nicola's defense, some of the mistakes some of these raiders were making were really, really quite fucking stupid. And they do them over and over. So I understood the frustration. So let's go to Battle of Dazar'alor. I was a bit behind the group because I had an upgrade and I was enchanting it. And I accidentally pulled a trash pack that they had skipped. It was heroic. We're on farm. It took us about 2 minutes to kill the trash. But Nicola lost his fucking mind! Are you blind? We always skip that trash. He said he doesn't have time to fuck around. And that I am not only wasting his time, but every other raider in the group. I barely spoke in voice comms unless I needed to do callouts. Dave would often tease me about this and try to encourage me to talk sometimes. I muttered a very meek,
sorry.
And Dave came to my rescue and said, at least you didn't prematurely pull the boss and wipe the raid like I did last week, mate. Do you remember when I was stoned and a ninja pulled the boss? Remember? It lightened the mood and everyone forgot about my mistake. Everyone but me. It plagued my mind for the whole run and I still think about that moment. That one ninja trash pull from time to time. As we move to the Crucible of Storms, we are stuck on the last boss on Heroic and we've been there for quite some time. Unat. I remember the raid constantly being screwed over because someone would be out of position. Nicola was angry every single raid. I hated this boss and I started to dread raid nights. I wasn't the only one, as around this time, people stopped showing up, particularly the healers. We had plenty of deeps, so the solution was for two deeps to go off spec. Unfortunately, the two deeps that were willing to heal were two of our best DPS, our better players. And although their healing was okay, you could tell it wasn't exactly their forte. We struggled on and on, wiping over and over and over to that giant bug. We did get to the last phase a couple of times, but we died. I'm not sure if it was because healing was low or because mechanics were done wrong. It was probably a mix of both. And the day before the next raid, I see a message has been put out. Nicola has an announcement for us all, graced on the guild Discord. There is a new healer. A healer that has killed Heroic Una. New healer is joining us. Combine that with our strongest DPS doesn't need to heal anymore, that he is confident Unat Heroic dies tomorrow. My spirits raise. Happiness. I'm sick to death of this boss and I just want to kill it. Nicola had promised once we had killed it on Heroic, we were not going to try Mythic. I'd just continue on Mythic Dazar'alor. We had only killed four bosses in there so far. Oh. I had work at 6 a.m, so I had an early night. I went to switch Sir Finley's lights off. And there I saw it. Sir Finley was lying at the bottom of the tank. He didn't come to greet me like usual. This wasn't super strange. I thought maybe he was sleeping, as fish do. But I did have a feeling that something wasn't right. I got through work the next day and I was feeling very anxious about Sir Finley the whole day. The first thing I do when I get home is greet him. Sir Finley was no more. I felt the tears well in my eyes and a few of them fell down my cheek. He'd had a bad start to life. But I thought at least I'd give him a nice end. I buried Sir Finley in the back garden, planted a white rose bush over his grave. I was depressed. And then it hit me. It's raid night. The thought of it actually made me a bit emotional, but I pulled myself together. I told myself, it's a game, Nicola will understand what I've gone through a loss, and I'm not really up to raiding tonight. Nicola didn't give a shit. Nicola did not understand. Nicola was furious. He couldn't believe that I was going to skip raid for a fish. He said if I'm not going to come, then he's cancelling the whole raid because he's not wasting time wiping again because some of these members of the team can't be bothered to show up on raid night. It made me feel guilty. I didn't want to ruin everyone else's night, so I said, fine, I'll come. Maybe it would take my mind off things. I logged into World of Warcraft to get my dailies done and we're chatting in the guild chat and I tell my guild about Sir Finley. They were nice about it even though I don't think they really understood how much it hurt me. Dave even said that Sir Finley sounded like, in his words, a rad fish. And that he was very sorry that Sir Finley had died. The raid begins and it does not go well. Nicola is angry and we are dying to the same old things again and again. The new healer and Nicola are arguing because apparently our tactics are shit. Nicola says he is the raid leader and you can't compare it to the way everyone else does it in a pug to how we do it in a guild. I think everyone is having a miserable time and a few people suggest doing Dazar'alor for a little chase and change of pace. But Nicola was adamant. Unat dies. Tensions are raising amongst the raid group. We can feel it. So a break is called. Dave pipes up in voice and says, hey lads, I'm having chippy tomorrow. Nice, another raider says. What are you having? I'm having Sir Finley and chips. Got him. The raid erupts with laughter. I even hear Tobias laughing amongst them. I'm hurt. I feel my bottom lip wobbling, my eyes filling up. It all came rushing back to me and I started to cry. Now, thank God I was on push to talk. I couldn't really make out what they were saying in voice though, through my hysteria, but I could hear them saying my name like they wanted a response. I felt betrayed. I had told them earlier how much Sir Finley may have been just a fish, but he meant a lot to me. And now they were mocking Sir Finley. Sadness turned to anger. And I did what I felt appropriate. I just switched off my PC. I sat there, upset. And in that moment, I regretted ever raiding at all. Ever trying to make friends in World of Warcraft. I should have stayed being a single solo player doing my old content. My phone goes off and it's Tobias. Have you DC'd? Nicola would like to pull. I ignore it. Tobias texts me again. Please don't say you're upset about the fish and Dave. It's just jokes, mate. Just a bit of bants. That's all. I turn off the notifications on my phone. Yes, I'm fucking upset, idiot, is what I thought. And I spent the rest of the night watching YouTube and feeling sorry for myself. Next day I wake, but I feel a little foolish. I truly believe the raiders were being insensitive, but at the time, maybe I overreacted. At this point, I thought I was sick of raiding, I'm sick of Nicola, and I sent a message in Discord. I explained to him that I think he's a bit of a bully, and that he bullied me into raiding. I said I know I overreacted, but I was very upset and had explained to him earlier in the day how I didn't even want to raid that night. I apologized for leaving the raid, but told him I should have stood up to him, and I should have not come at all. I could have ended it there, but instead it got carried away. I said it would have made no difference if I was there or not in the end, because we just wiped like we always do. That it's no wonder sign-ups are starting to get poor with his attitude. Raiding isn't even fun lately, with your little outburst and your little anger, and I'm currently thinking if I even want to be in this guild anymore. And I hit the send button. I tapped back into WoW and I just stood there in Boralus and thought, fuck, did I really want to do that? Shit. 10 minutes later, I hear the noise notifying me that Nicola has come online. Nicola throws me a message in the pink. Let me help you make up your mind. Smile. I was removed from the guild. I logged off the game and went to play something else. I felt a mix of emotions, anxiety, regret, relief, actually. I saw that I'd also been kicked from the guild Discord and had more messages from Tobias, who was just like, what in the fuck is going on? Is this about the fish? Is it about the fish? Is that what it is? I explained to him what happened. He said he understands that Sir Finley meant a lot to me, but I must also understand that to most people, Sir Finley is a fish. Does that matter, friends? They didn't mean to upset me. They just can't sympathize about the fish. He said that perhaps I'm a bit too sensitive. He told me I should apologize to Nicola. 10 out of 10. Best advice. Best friend ever. But I said, no! No! I need a break from WoW, I told him. He tried to convince me to stay and told me I don't have to raid and you can still do other things you enjoyed in the game. But it was too late. Fuck World of Warcraft. Fuck it. I was done. I wished him luck with being an raider, and I cancelled my WoW subscription. I have just resubbed, though, to World of Warcraft. Ready for the pre-patch in the Shadowlands, whenever that will be now. Tobias has quit WoW shortly after 8.2. He said it was way too tedious and boring, and that the Essence system sucked a cock. Fair enough. Nicola got mad at him for letting the guild down because he was the only other tank and he was also removed from the guild. We decided to transfer to a more populated realm and are now playing catch up with each other whilst we wait for pre-patch. I don't think I'll ever raid again. Maybe at all. My first experience wasn't a great one, although it did have its fun moments. I do have quite a few more pets and inevitably when they pass away, I can't guarantee that I won't react in the same way. This also probably goes without saying, but I never made a single penny from World of Warcraft, never mind the fortune that I thought I was going to make when I was 12 years old. Thank you for reading my story. RIP, Sir Finley. Can we get a salute to Sir Finley? You did well with Sir Finley. You did all right with Sir Finley. Sir Finley lived a good life. A rough start, but found a caring home and was looked after. Also, fuck those guys for trashing you for being upset. Fuck you. Fucking I'll get upset about anything. Eventually, my dog will die. I'm aware of that. And I'm going to have to deal with that. And there's going to be some douchebags on the tweet machine or in stream chat going, ooh, your dog died. Fuck you, man. All right? We've been through some shit. Yeah? Ben will live forever. Fingers crossed. Fingers crossed. Fingers crossed. Right. Let's cheer the mood up a little bit. Have you ever been paid to leave a group? Now, we've had some bad players in our time. We have. We have. But how bad could you be? How bad could you be? Is that a yes? I see some of you saying yes. Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. Okay. Okay, we need a couple of names here. Let's go with Ian. Let's get you in. Let's go with Peter. These are all names that are hard for me to distinguish you guys for when we, you know, need $10. Try and put a name that you know. That can make it work. I think we need a warrior. I think we need another name later on. But I'll put that in as and when we get there. That should make a whole lot more sense. And Ripley. Perfect. All right. Name shaming? It's just, it's hard. Because a lot of people ask me, like, when was my name used in drama time? But if several people are called, like, you know, Ian, it's hard for me to say exactly when, you know? It's hard for me to name that out. Okay. Preacher, audience, I have a question for you. Have you ever been offered money to leave a group? Allow me to set the scene. It is 3:10 a.m. on a school night. You still use the phrase on a school night, so we can accept that you're probably young. Location? Kul Taras. Baralis Harbor stinks at that hour. It always stinks. Only the drowsiest insomniacs, servicemen stationed in Guam and lost us. Oh, side bet. I need to side bet this. Do you remember last week we had a drama story about the guy who said he was like ex in the military with the Apache crash and all that kind of stuff? Dude, did you piss off the viewers of the show who are in the military? Do you know how many people fucking emailed me from the military like denouncing that motherfucker? Let me scroll on real quick. Like, so many people were like, no, no. Oh, here's one. Yeah, here's one. Here's what I got on Wednesday. Preach, I've watched every video you've put out since playing WoW back in the middle of Firelands. You nailed it when you said this guy definitely wasn't in the military. However, as someone that served in the US Army, I want to point out something that this completely debunks the claim of him being home on leave after an accident in Afghanistan in an Apache helicopter. First, he claimed to be a fighter pilot in the Air Force. That would mean this guy's flying fighter jets. Jets, not helicopters. Second, the Apache is part of the Army. Attack helicopters in general are part of the Army and Marines, not the Air Force. Lastly, I've attached a screenshot from Boeing's website, the manufacturer of the AH-64 Apache. I've circled and read two key points. I want to point out the lack of any mention of the US Air Force anywhere on Boeing's website. Finally, I want to say thank you for your content and for standing up for the veterans in this episode. Dude, like, I have like 20 of these. But we all know, you didn't need to prove it. We could all smell the shit, but I appreciate the effort. I genuinely do appreciate the effort. But like, I got like 20 of these from the armed services who were like, yo, fuck that guy. Fuck that guy. Seriously, fuck that guy. Big, yeah, it was just, that brought it up for me then. Fuck that guy. I'm not reading them all. They're very similar to that. Very to the point and very pissed off. Every person I've met who's been in the armed services, whether it be the US, the UK or whatever, fucking hates people who pretend they were in the military. They're like, screw you, dude. We went through some shit and you're pretending, sat at home in your ass playing fucking video games. Shut the fuck up. Anyway. Let's go. It's 3:10 a.m. It's a school night in Kul Taras. Baralis Harbor stinks. Even the NPCs who hand out world quests seems to say, dude, go to fucking bed, loser. I opened the group finder. You don't open the group finder at 3 a.m. you don't open the group finder at 3 a.m. Oh, my God. I peer at the text through my crispy red eyes. There are three dungeon groups forming. Time walking times five, go, go. Okay, which one would you guys pick? It's a dark, dark place, it is. All right, these are the three groups. Apparently, Group Finder has only three groups in it. These are your choices. Time walking times five, go, go. Free carries on stream, smile. And a freehold 16. The free carries? I've never done that because we just run them through stream, but I'm kind of fortunate. There's usually a few of you here, so we don't have to do that. Do you have to like rate and subscribe or what to get in these free stream groups or what? I don't know. So I assume the plan is just to get people to come and check out the stream, which is fine. I have no issue with that. Hopefully you don't have to follow and prove it or anything like that. I sign up for the freehold 16. Nothing happens. Water laps against the shore. I can hear the cogs grinding in the group leader's brain. My IO score is bad. He's concerned, I can tell. Why do I have the item level of 474, but my raider.io is like a fresh scrub? He's checking me out. He's seen that I never do most of these dungeons. It's like me. It's like me. Oh my god. Oh, the amount of people who check my IO and see that I don't do all these dungeons. Like, oh my god. He's deciding to invite me anyway, though, because it's 3 o'clock in the fucking morning and there's no one else around. Sure enough, my invite arrives. My flight form bugs and I swim through the air to freehold as a night elf because science has given up this day. It's given up. My group fills up. The leader is a mage. We have a demon hunter tank, a windwalker monk, a warrior, and I am playing my resto druid. It's not until we're lined up at the start that I realize that three of these gentlemen are in the same guild. Only the warrior and I are outsiders. Checking out their gear, it looks like the mage is giving his buddies a carry and need a couple of people to fill out the group. Fine with me. I okay the ready check, the timer starts, and I get a bit comfier in my chair. I throw out the early life bloom on the DH. I am ready to disco. The first pirates look annoyed, like we got them out of bed to do the dungeon. Even Sharkbait can't be bothered to crap on us. Plus 16 without bursting is no problem for my healer. I'm just on automatic mode, barely even paying attention. It's all fine until suddenly the DH is gone. He's not in loss. He's not on my screen. He's vanished. Actually, they've all gone, and now they're all dead. I look at my chat. What's a good mage voice? Healer? Where'd you go? I asked as they res. Pillar, says the mage, heading back to it with the rest of the group. Yeah, pillars. Lol. I remember, and I tried to run down the hill to the pillar, but my cameras got all turned around. What does that mean? My cameras all turned. He actually says that. My cameras all. Whoa! My camera! I run the wrong way and straight into a pack of trash and I die. The warrior responds with the three dots of shame. I don't say a word. I just res up again and follow them down. Can we go now? Asked the mage. Go, I say. We enter the pillar and fight the mobs while the demon hunter drags the big thing up to the boss area. I lose control a bit and I have to pop tranquility. Then I fall off a ledge in tree form and have to race to catch back up. What are you doing, dude? What's happening here? Mister, it's dead easy. I'm on automatic. You're falling off ledges. It's a trash. You're using trank as an actual cooldown? What's happening? What's happening? Okay. I'm a bit slow. You're a druid. What do you mean? The warrior and monk both die. He's high as fuck. There's an element we're missing, right? You can feel it. This is you're a druid who's a bit slow. Okay. The warrior and monk both die. I should probably mention now that I've been drinking since dinner. And dinner was a long time ago. Oh, okay, okay. I don't believe you, by the way. Just point it out there. I was drunk, bro. I don't believe it. I don't believe it. I don't believe it. We exit the portal in the boss area and wait for the melee to run back. Freehold is pretty at night. I find myself gazing across at the peaceful, torchlit town. You're totally high. You're like, oh, wow. Look at that. There's pirates in here. Sick. Oh, you're all dead. Oh. I feel a stab of regret at the violence we're inflicting on these pirates. When the warrior arrives, the DH gives me a slash poke. Are you sure you could do this? 16 is really easy, I say. The group doesn't have huge deeps and the boss fights take a while. This gives me plenty of time to fuck it up, which I do. I'm merrily swift mending the DPS when my screen flashes red. Apparently I'm standing in a pool of pirate shit and it kills me. The rest of the group soon follows. Why are you sending this story in? Everybody hates you. Why? Silently we res and run back. The demon hunter pulls the boss again. This time I'm careful about the ship pools. It's fine until I lose my position and run into the trash. Motherfuckers! Yells the warrior as it all goes to hell and we wipe. Now, I address you, Mike, and audience. Gentlemen, in these situations, the gut instinct is to take the blame and apologize. Now, in the pug world, this is incorrect. The proper response in the pug world is to parry and riposte. I say, warrior keeps wiping us. Sterling performance. Oh my god, warrior keeps wiping us. Mage, who hasn't seen what's happening, warrior be more careful, okay? What the fuck, says the warrior. The monk, who is trying to teach his newfound warrior, educates him on the matter. Warrior, it's not worth staying in the crap just for a bit of extra DPS. So, don't go near the trash again, or we'll wipe again. The demon hunter then chimes in, showing that nobody was paying any attention. Warrior, just stay in melee. I'll move the boss so you can't get in trouble. Aww. This fucking warrior is about to literally suicide out of his window. Oh my god. I see that this is working. So I add my two cents to this conversation. Maybe we should put down a marker for the warrior so he knows where the safe spot is. The warrior is getting pissed and in all caps says, "It wasn't me!" I decide to like have fun with this. So I whisper him, lol. He tells me I'm a fucking prick. I'm waiting, because I'm pretty sure the group's going to fall apart. But it doesn't. The group stays together. We travel back through the portals, pull the boss, and we kill him. Now, I lose track of the group again, crossing over the chasm. Two of the three hamsters that power my brain have stopped running and the bulb is getting dim. I suspect each time I blink my eyes, they are staying shut for a few seconds. I battle res the DH on the other side. The pirate boss is impossible. I just can't. No matter where I stand, Eudora is shooting at me. It just keeps happening over and over again. As I scamper back across the chasm in cat form, a whisper shows up from the mage. I will legitimately pay you 5,000 gold to leave this group right now. Why? I ask why. It's because you're terrible. And I really don't want to disappoint my friends by calling off the dungeon. Please leave. 20k, I reply. Why not? No, he says. We bypass the captain's boss and head for the arena. Once again, I lose track of the group for a minute and the monk and warrior die. Okay, 10k, says the mage. 25, I say. "20," he says. 30, I counter. Perhaps realizing this isn't going his way, the mage changes plans. Oh no, guys, my power is going out, he types as he disconnects. The warrior, not understanding what's happening, and seemingly maybe new to the game, types in all caps. How did he type it then? I think he's bullshitting. I don't think this is true at all. Mates, I'm pretty sure he's lying. I fucking got what's going on here. This is bullshit. Totally is. He's joking, says the monk. I just pipe up saying he offered me 20,000 to just quit this dungeon, I say. Lol, what a noob, says the warrior. The demon hunter, the three dots of shame. The mage reconnects. Instantly, I get a whisper. Dude, why are you still in the group? Why are you still in the group? Why? The group stops in place right outside the arena. Moments pass in silence. While I guess the guildies are talking on Discord. The warriors running up and down some stairs. I'm actually relatively happy looking at the moonlight glittering on the sea in the distance. What the fuck are you doing to this group, man? Like, it's entertaining for us, but please leave the fucking group. I will pay you to leave this group. I swear to fucking God. I will pay you to leave this group. Let them go. This is hostages, is what you've got here. You're just deliriously fucking dribbling around the world. Like, what the fuck? Suddenly, the monk quits the group and then the demon hunter. The mage just whispers. Almost you can hear the dejection in his voice. Fuck you, man. And he ports out. Seriously, though, says the warrior. After all this! He then emotes a slash sigh and hearths away. I am alone in the arena. Or am I? I look around. The pirates sit on a rough-hewn furniture, singing and swigging their grog. Parrots nest in the palms. It's actually quite pretty. There's no curfew in Freehold. No unemployment. What are you doing? What are you doing? Really? What are you doing? There's no elections. There's no riots. There's no COVID in Freehold. I mean, that's like... I start to think that about all of Azeroth, life is better here in Freehold. I switch to bear form and I start dancing under the stars for my new pirate comrades. Then as my wife you're not married. No, you're not. Tell your wife this story. I dare you. I dare you to let her listen to this story. I double dare you. I swear to God. You get your wife in here and let her listen to this story. All right? I lie on the couch watching my screen until I finally fall asleep pretty happy after my big night. Thank you for reading. I did not complete my dungeon. Good. Really good. It must be fake. I doubt it very seriously. I mean, do you think it's really fake that some guy was shit in Freehold? Does that sound fake to you? Did he get the 20k? He did not. He did not get his 20k. He did not get his 20k. But he had a wife. That can't be true. I don't know, man. I've seen a lot of dodgy people have wives. That does bring us to the end of drama time, because I'm going to get on with your wee chorus. So that is how it's going to be. We're going to get it done there. Can we have one more final F for Sir Finley? A memory of Sir Finley. It's only 5 minutes early. Like, come on, man. So, come on. It's only 5 minutes early. Don't worry. And we've had hour and a half long drama times the last 3 weeks. We're good. I have a lot of wonderful stories. Thank you for tuning in this week. Watch for the UI video. I'll have it out to you over the weekend. Please, once again, I remind you, if you are going to use the Shadowlands UI, it does have all your Legos and Soulbind stuff in it. Please test it on the PTR. Don't install it on retail. And then tweet me that it doesn't work. All right? It's a Shadowlands UI. It works in the Shadowlands with the Shadowlands updated add-ons. Please don't do that to me. Okay? Please don't do that to me. I beg of you. I really do. Will it be okay during pre-patch? Yes. Pre-patch is the Shadowlands. In pre-patch, it's fine. PTR, it's fine. Beta, it's fine. Current retail before pre-patch, not fine. No good. Bad. Bad taste. All right? Don't do that. All right? Thank you, everybody, for a wonderful day. I hope you're all feeling good. Thank you for the subs we got, especially in the last few minutes. Have a wonderful, wonderful evening. I should be around tomorrow. We do have the giveaways of the beta keys to give away, and I have this press kit to give away, which I'm not going to show you because it's in pristine condition, and it's a collector's item. So we'll do that then. Because
all our ballers and a bro fist to you all! We have had a hell of a day, because no doubt right now, if you're watching this live, we are buffering, we are chopping up, and it might not get better. And there's nothing I could do about it. There's absolutely nothing I could do about it. I can sit here on my throne of justice, yet it does not help the fact that Virgin Media is doing something to our line. And they've been doing it for the last 2 days, and our internet is kind of up and down and all over the goddamn place, but that's okay. That's okay. That's fine. That's fine. You want to play me like a fiddle? That's fine. You ain't stopping me, son. You ain't stopping the show. It's not going to happen. We're going to push through this. And all the way through drama time, I would really appreciate it if every single last one of you could point out when this frame drops, right? Because we really don't notice it. So if you could comment continuously, that would be really helpful. Yeah? Just constantly, like, in fact, you know, why don't you update us as it goes to let us know that everything is fine? That would be awesome. That would be really cool. Indeed, Mega Corona Lockdown is in 2 hours' time. Wunderbar! Wunderbar. Not that I've been out of the house in a year's time. Anyway, who cares, man? Who cares? It's all good. Lock me down. Lock me down. I hope you've had a wonderful week. Besides the last 2 days, it's been a little bit amazing, with Blizzard making amazing changes to the Shadowlands. Why is my light not on? What the fuck? I'm sat in gloom, dude. Illuminates. Ah, I feel so much better now. I feel like life returned to me. I feel like blood flowed through my face once more as we enter into the drama time. The drama time this week contains darkness, misery, just great sadness from all concerned. Great sadness, and I hope you're ready for it. I hope you're ready for it. It's an unbelievably overwhelming amount of sadness that should be befalling many of you. But I will open with this, because of course Drama Time is here. I want to open with an email from a regular viewer of Drama Time, who is just sending us a message to let us know. Mike, I need to inform you of something. My longtime girlfriend has finally picked up World of Warcraft. A risky move, as we all know, is to bring the partners into World of Warcraft. What direction? What if they're a noob? It can happen to any of us. She started playing around 10 a.m. on a Saturday. She became instantly hooked and addicted. She played World of Warcraft for 12 hours straight. I asked her if she wanted to have sex and go to bed that night. She said, after I tame this turtle. She did not come to bed that night. She has since found a husband and wife social guild, and she joined. I warned her, but she responded with a, you're just being negative. Now, combining this with the denial of sex, I decided to sit back and let the drama unfold on its own. I'm just letting you know, Mike, that I will post regular updates as to how this goes on. We can look forward to it. We can look forward to it. One action leading to a consequence. Equal and opposite. Sex? Yes, but soon. No sex. Husband and wife guild. Husband and wife guild is exactly the resort. There they are. They're watching. They're watching every single last one of you waiting to ruin your World of Warcraft experience. And we will wait with bated breath to see how that plays out. Now, over the course of drama time, ladies and gentlemen, we have had a selection of individuals who could be considered as the worst guild masters that could have ever existed. Yet today our author says, hold my beer. Hold my beer. Because have I got a tale for you. She claims to us this is the worst GM known to mankind. As we have a righteous jury amongst us, with gavels at the ready, I am pretty sure that we can be the appropriate judges as to whether or not this is, in fact, the worst guild master known to mankind. Now, we'll need a couple of names for this, of course. And considering the topic at hand. We will start with the GM's name, which will be put randomly from a hat, by the way. I literally reached into a raffle box and pulled out this name. We will go with the Dresdas as potentially the guild master's name. I think that seems appropriate to me. We'll pick up another name as we go along. But I think this is totally fine. I think this is accurate and fair. And it should be the way it goes. Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready to hear of the tale of the worst GM known to mankind? It does say we need a boyfriend's name. The Chad boyfriend. He's definitely going to outplay this. Perfect. Okay. Nailed it. Okay. Excellente. All right. Greetings, Preach, and the awful and lovely chat. Pick a side, team. Pick a side, team. I love you all dearly, so please be gentle to me. Good luck. I wish you the best. I do wish you the best. My tale starts in sadness and the swamp of sorrows that is a dying EU server. I had previously played World of Warcraft, thanks to your videos, for a few months, the last few weeks of Warlords of Draenor, and into the start of Legion. I couldn't afford my World of Warcraft subscription anymore. My guild was also falling apart due to loot drama. The signs were clear. I took a hiatus and gave it a little break. But let me take you back to April 2020. I saw my friends immersed in World of Warcraft. They're playing it. They're having so much fun. Me and my boyfriend, Jono, decided it's time. We must return to Azeroth. And we joined in. I told him straight. Listen, Jono, little bitch. I might try hard. However, it was not my plan. But it is my nature to try hard. We began playing and we were somewhat fresh to the game. I had only played Disciplined Priest in the past and a Hunter on the Horde side. However, I was told that the new guild was to be on the Alliance. Oh, bastard. Unlucky. Shit. What a rough start. This is a rough start to the story. This is where you're going to find these guild masters. This is why you want to play on the Horde. This is what I'm saying. I rolled a human Mistweaver Monk. I'd been eyeing that bad boy up since Legion because they had always looked pretty goddamn cool. Jono and I pugged our way up in Heroic and M+, and in the next few weeks we are able to join a Mythic Raiding Guild with our 475+ item level. I had started to learn. Knowledge was entering me. I had begun to optimize. I was optimizing my gear, optimizing my class to the best of my ability. I wrote out the crispest of applications for a guild that was 7 out of 12 mythic. What's the name of that guild? Oh, I know what it should be for today. It shall be Stature of the Gods. In tribute. The Stature of the Gods. Otherwise, it would be a hilariously rude name from our chat. I sent an application for a guild called Stature of the Gods that was 7 out of 12 mythic. Big boys. We were invited to join Raid Team 2 and progress with Raid Team 2. Maybe 300 wipes on Shadar. What? Oh, that's unlucky. 300 wipes on Shadar? What? It's just a dog. What the fuck? Oh, bummer. I could feel my soul leaving my body every time I got the invite to join that raid. My nightmares were full of, please just feed the dog. Just feed it. Somebody, please just feed the dog. And it echoes in my mind whenever I see that fucking pupper. I eventually left, as they said they were not going to raid anymore for the rest of Battle for Azeroth. I don't blame you. Shadar? Come on, man. But there it was, another guild. 9 out of 12. They were nice. My first raiding night with them was their Ilganoth kill. I hated that fight, since they had me simply sat in one of the tanks with one more DPS and heal them during the organ phase. That was my whole job. I basically healed 5 people at most during that fight. They also quickly stopped raiding. I felt like I was cursed. No matter where I went, the guilds died. And then on that fateful night, me and Jono hung around in Boralus. We're dueling while waiting for an M+ pug to farm after midnight. Him and a rogue start goofing off, showing off their Jane amounts, and the rogue starts talking. He speaks of a guild, his guild. They are big boys. They are 11 out of 12. And all they lack for their full team power is a healer. He weighs up my gear, even double checks my corruptions, looking good. I remember watching one of them stream the raid and hearing the guild master, Dresdaz, asking other people about that Mistweaver monk. Must have been me. An invite appeared on my screen and I went in. Now obviously each guild raids a little differently. Their tactics, not quite as exact as the same as I was used to. And it was kind of new. I had seen most of these bosses just once, despite my rating inside of the guilds. I did better than the other monk, though. And Dresdaz added me on Battle.net. I had been told, Dresdaz is about to recruit you. My boyfriend Jono stepped away from raiding. Guilds just weren't looking for DK DPS. They all kind of wanted healers. He looked me in the eye and said, he's holding me back from my raiding pursuits. I didn't think so. It's just that if he'd rolled a fire mage, he'd have more luck. Okay, you've just cooked your fella hard. It's okay, you're not holding me back. Just roll a good class, yeah? Just roll a good class. Do yourself a favor, yeah? Just roll something fucking useful for once, you useless bastard. You know what I mean? DK, Nihilotha. The first raid night after officially joining the guild. Everything's going well. I joined them, and the first night as a guildie, gambling starts taking place in the chat. How many of your guilds gamble when there's downtime? Mine does. Gambling is no joke. Don't piss about with the gambling. Don't piss about with the gambling. Don't mess around when it comes to the gambling. I had never seen in-game gambling taking place, but it looked like fun. So I decided I would join in. On the first round, I lose. So I jokingly say, this is my first time. Surely I don't have to pay just for the first loss. As I ran into Carapace's room. Now I was wrong. I was wrong, I understand that. Of course, I opted into the gambling session. I lost. I should have paid. However, what I didn't expect was one of the guildies to call me a greedy fucking N-word and to get back and pay him right now. That I found a little strange. I kind of just stood there, dumbfounded. Not sure what to do. I even opened my bags to Hearthstone. Like, what's happening here? Where did that come from? Why is this happening to me? And then I looked back, though, because you know what else was there? There was Nuzoth, though. Quit our purples. Quit our purples. What was also bizarre is no one else in the raid team seemed to react at all. In any way, shape, or form. They were just going about their business, doing the next rounds of gambling and laughing. I felt like I was in some sort of upside-down world. So I go and pay the man. while weighing my choices, and I decide I'm going to stick it out. Because I really did want cutting edge. And having cutting edge 2.5 to 3 months after starting playing the game feels much better than pushing Mythic Plus keys. And as your chat probably is aware, did I make a big fucking mistake? We eventually plan a reclear as not enough people showed up to progress. So I threw an invite to Jono, my boyfriend. I asked, is it okay if my SO comes along? Jono thinks he's a funny guy. So as he joins the raid on his 7 out of 12 less than geared everyone's character, he rolls in.
Ah, sup, nerds? Heard you need a carry, did it, mate? You need a carry, though. I'm here. Got you guys. Sorted this, mate.
The guild did not like that. They did not like it all. Later that week, one of my guildies persuades me to join voice chat with Dresdaz. Him and a couple of other people. It took him around an hour to encourage me to actually get into voice comms with him. I join and I have some anxiety. I didn't like it. I'm unable to really speak other than to stutter and make some little noises for a bit. They assumed that I didn't really understand the language. Feels bad, man. Actually, her words. It just feels bad, man. However, after 20 minutes or so, I start to relax. I was able to start joining in a little bit more. Dresdaz asked me if it was me in my Discord photo. I say yes. He says, Not a good sound effect. I think you'll agree. I've knocked over a tripod. Hold on. Ooh, I'm surrounded by tripods. Hit the button. Drez. I respond quite immediately. That's not happening. I'm not interested. I have a boyfriend. He's genuinely appalled that I haven't mentioned my boyfriend before. So Jai said, I did. I literally told you the first time we spoke. Do you not know what SO means? Oh, he says, you mean significant other. He responded, offended. Genuinely offended. We're almost there. We're almost there. Fuck it. We're going there because we're on a downhill streak, guys. I'm letting you know now. We're on a very downhill streak. Later on, I receive a whisper that he thinks and has tried putting out raid warnings and other such messages attacking me, that is how he comes on to the girls in the guild. And I should be aware of it. Good note. Eventually, as time goes on, everyone else but me and Dresdaz are left in the voice comms channel. We're chilling. We decided we're going to run a few visions. And this is where he got very, very strange. As we're talking, he kind of unravels a little bit. He starts telling me stories. And the more and more he tells me these stories, I tell him that he's just a fucking liar. And I swear to you, chat, every single story he told me, I just said, none of that is true. None of that is true. He told me how he's only ever had one low DPS pass. And he remembers it vividly. I can't speak today. I've been talking for 8 hours. Shut up. He remembers it vividly. And the reason he once got a low DPS pass is because he had operated on himself. I was like, what do you mean? He then goes on to tell me the story of his own surgery. You see, he had a stomach ulcer, and it was really being painful. So he decided to open his own stomach slightly to close the ulcer and then stitch himself up rather than going to the hospital. I, of course, told him that he's absolutely full of shit. And that's not even remotely possible. Anyone would just go to a doctor. He then tries to convince me that he once ate a casserole that involved part of his own leg muscle. You see, he tells me, he had gone to a doctor and had to get some meat removed. He was able to take it home with him, so he thought I should cook it. I asked him, what kind of fucking doctor would even... Why are you saying this? It's hazardous. It's not even remotely possible. He then insinuates that he gets surgery done by a shady black market doctor because it's faster. I, of course, follow along with what your chat is probably thinking and tell him that anybody who would ever believe this kind of stuff is fucking stupid or sucking up to you or simply not listening to his crap. I say it laughing to not offend him. I don't get kicked from the guild. And so he literally just keeps carrying on. The final straw, of course, is when he starts to boast. He tells me he has dated every single girl that was in this guild. And how lucky I am. Because him and his girlfriend are quite happy right now. How lucky we are. I later found out that these were his regular come-on-to-girls stories, as they found them interesting, even if they were clearly lies. Okay, can I recommend something to every single one of you guys? Don't try this. You know? Just saying. Virgin GM. Lucky. Oh, she's so lucky. Imagine getting to spend more and more time with this guy. What a dream. Imagine the wonder of spending so much more time with Dresdaz. What a joy that would be for anybody. Have I tried it, though? You know, I haven't tried it. I haven't tried trying to impress a girl with cannibalism. We do have a large female audience here. Can we get a thumbs up, thumbs down on the cannibalism as a potential come online? Is it hilarious? Is it a really fun story? Over the course of my time in the guild, we did get into several conversations. And honestly, it was kind of... This is how it works. This is how it fucking works. This is it. I find it intriguing to listen to the things he says. No! Stop encouraging this behavior. For the love of God. I beg of you. I get what you mean, and maybe I'm saying this, but I would actually still kind of want to listen to this guy talk for a few minutes. But, I mean, we should stop this, right? We should put a stop to it. It did get even worse, though. Of course it did. How it possibly got worse than this, I don't know. But, okay, yeah, I do. I can read it. He decides to get into politics. Awesome. I would expect nothing short but level-headed, good discourse on the issues. He tells me that one thing he really hates is the censoring of racial slurs because it's against his freedom and rights. Right. There you go. I immediately shut that down. He then begins to bring up that death knight. Of course, you guys know that. He's Jono, my boyfriend. That I brought in that day to re-clear. He casually brings up that death knight, although he definitely knows it's my boyfriend, is no longer allowed to spend time near our guild. He said he'd had feedback that that guy is a nerd. And that is not something that's welcome in our guild. No nerds in the World of Warcraft guild, guys. All right? No nerds because we're too cool. Yeah? We're too cool. Tunnel snakes forever. Tunnel snakes forever. No nerds in the World of Warcraft Fantasy Guild. None at all, right? I want you to stay clear. I really do, yeah? We want to be... We're so cool in this guild. It's unreal. Big load of casual racism thrown around. We're good. I'm obviously getting tired after one of these late night conversations and I go off to sleep. After this, though, I rarely ever spoke to him. It was just too bizarre. I was even asked to go for certain bosses, felt unnecessary, as that meant I had to speak directly to him. I would message that same rogue back in the day to ask for a boss I could get in, but I really wanted to avoid the raid. I stuck to some of my heroic Azerite gear just to avoid being around Dresdas. Loot's not even worth it anymore. I don't know. I don't know why you guys stay in guilds like this. Every week. And I'm not just talking about drama time. Literally every single day of every single week where we're streaming and streaming, people are just in this scenario and you stay.
like there's going to be some sort of cleansing or purge that's going to just fix the whole situation from start to finish. You just stick around. Every raid night, more and more racist behavior began to show. It was clear that as I'd been around for a while, that they had begun to relax and be themselves. Great. I started to grow resentful, full of hate for most of the guild. Eventually, I couldn't take it. I called up my friend on Discord, having an anxiety attack, telling him everything. Jono was also in the call. They were just pleading with me, just leave. Please, just leave. Like, what the fuck? I was so worried about not finding a guild again that was capable of killing us off. My passes were blue because we were 4 healing on Mythic. And I know so many guilds look more at passes than they do performance. But cutting edge, though. Cutting edge. They say I should make a statement and steal something from the guild bank and leave. What is the lamest thing you could steal in Battle for Azeroth? What is the absolute lamest thing you could steal? None of you will get this. This is so lame. It's it's unreal to me. An actual item. This is BFA. I see a stack of 200 verse gems. Isn't that like 6 golds worth of stuff? Verse gems? Really? Verse gems? What the fuck? What the fuck? I take them. I'm shaking and hyperventilating at the same time with the anxiety and excitement. I type, sup nerds, thanks for the gems, see ya. And I G-quit. Immediately my chat tab starts to fill up. Ping, 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 flying in from all directions. Most of them are telling me how much they hate the guild too. And they wanted to hang out with me and they liked my voice. Oh my god, the simp army. And will I be able to still do M plus with them? And the only reason that they're different than the gang that's around Dresdas. The whisper comes from Drez himself, though, and I ignore him. He logs into an alt, messages me again. I look at it for 5 minutes, thinking, what am I going to tell Drez? What is the words for this man? And all I can think to say is, you're just an awful human being. So I want you to look at me now. Dresdas, you're just an awful human being. And that anybody playing World of Warcraft making a big deal about being called a nerd sarcastically is just a loser. I also started getting messages on Battle.net telling me about how he wanted to sue his guildies for getting cutting edge on another raid without him while he was busy having life-threatening surgery. There were so many stories about Drez. So many stories. He's a unique guy in the worst way I have ever seen. I found a different guild. And these are the issues that I have run into there. Issue number 1 was a guy asking if I wanted to get spanked by him, of course. I'm sorry, girls. I am genuinely sorry. I am. I am genuinely sorry. I really am. I really am. But, I mean, in the same respect, though, a lot of my guildies have asked to spank me, too. I just don't think they meant it. I'm pretty sure these guys did. And there's several guys just telling me that I sound hot. That is not even the closest or the worst I've dealt with compared to Dresdas. I think this might actually be my forever guild. That's such a low bar. It's like a crazy low bar. Right? That is a crazy low bar. All there are is guys simping over my voice and saying they want to spank me. Forever Guild. Nailed it. Nailed it. Absolutely nailed it. Oh my god.
2 months later, I get a message on Battle.net from someone from a nice guild. The one where I killed Ilganoth. He also left that guild the same day I left the guild to progress and Nazoth elsewhere. He's telling me how a lot of people helped that guild get cutting edge by carrying them. 2 days before the pre-patch. That guild that I left, they never got past the second phase of Psychus. The one time they did, they instantly wiped. So I made the right decision. Also, apparently they have a stream on Twitch now, after a few being told of them making shitty remarks about my stream and being too small and no one will ever watch my Twitch channel. And anyone who ever did watch my Twitch channel will only do it because I'm a woman. I hope I never hear from any of those people ever again. Thank you for reading my little story. I've been watching you for 6 years, mainly on YouTube. You're on my second monitor while I paint. Hello. And I've always wondered if I'd have a story worth writing. I have a few little stories to tell you. English isn't my first language and my brain just speeds. But thank you very much for reading. Well, that's all well and good, but we have a decision to make, audience. Is Dresdaz the worst GM we have ever heard on Drama Time? We've had some crackers in my time. We have had some crackers. I think the super racism and political views takes it over the edge. Dresdaz, I, Chief Justice Preach of the Court, dub thee. Wait for it. Oh, it's not here. Guilty. The worst GM that has ever graced our stories. The worst. The absolute worst. Let's hear about some absolute fucking idiots. No chance the worst. I don't know. The extreme racism then mixed in with the political view, right? That's what you've got to remember. You've got to remember the political view to then be defending it. No memery. None of that. Just the straight argument that it should be allowed. I mean, it was pretty bad. I really do dislike that the Forever Guild is one where you're only risking being spanked. Or wanting to be spanked, I suppose. I mean, sure, that's your Forever Guild. If that's what you want to do. Auto-cannibalism. He sounded creepy. He sounds like he's trying way, way, way too hard. Way, way, way too hard to be that special guy. Two idiots in the Shadowlands. Because, of course, the beta and the alphas, they only go to the creme de la creme of the protesters, as we guys well know. It's going to be good. It's going to be good. Why don't you ever offer to spank us? Hard to say. Preacher, this story might save some of your viewers stress, disappointment, and heartache when the Shadowlands comes. I will say this, the beta has been kind to me. I got my invite in the big delay wave. I leveled smoothly with the help of a hunter friend. Oh, let's bring him in. Let's bring in hunter friend. Let's see if we can pop this off. Yeah. Torios. The hunter friend. With the help of a hunter friend called Torios, who had been in the beta already for several weeks. The zones. So cool. So beautiful. So gorgeous. The music is the best since Mists of Pandaria. I don't know about that. Music's okay, though. Torios gave me lots of insightful hints like, mate, only healers and cowards play with war mode off. You not got any balls, is you? Why are you reporting bugs, though? Trying to be some sort of tryhard. And the ultimate one, mate, you have to be Venfear though. Kyrian is for like mega nerds. And Nightfae is for furries. And I've got to say, like, it's for neckbeards and shit. Well, that kind of narrows it down. I ignored that last one and picked Kyrian because I like the dong sound when you hit Divine Toll. (Clears throat) Hell of a reason to choose. Didn't see that one coming, did you, Ian? When you were making your big meaningful choice. All about the dong, mate. All about the dong, Ian. Did you think about the dong? What if you gave Benthea a dong? That guy could have had two choices. Didn't think about it, did you? Got to think on. Tiara showed me how to get around some game-breaking bugs, making my life much easier. The bugs I did see were mostly harmless and amusing, like the day the entire server received an alert every time someone was targeted with an earthquake attack in the Maldraxxus arena. Tiara's and I joined with everyone else in whispering that person, "Run, motherfucker!" "Did you die, mate?" to whoever set off the alert. I was never imprisoned by an approaching Fatewalker. This one I have never seen, no matter how much I have played it. Nobody ever turned into a block of wood. I have never seen that on the Shadowlands beta. But loads of you have. I have never had that happen where someone turned into a block of wood. Or the NPCs turned into blocks of wood. I haven't had that. I feel kind of like I've missed out. I did no dungeons at all on my leveling journey. So at level 60, I decided it was time for the Dungeon World Tour. Zora's was offline, so I queued alone. I smashed 3 heroic dungeons in a row. They were super easy because my deeps was in fucking sane, dude. Like, for reals. I was doing nearly double the damage of most of the other players. For the first time in World of Warcraft, guys, I felt like a god. An absolute monster. My DPS was so high that at the end of Plaguefall, I couldn't resist linking the damage meters to the group. I followed it with this comment. Ret pallies are really strong. Smile. The response? Yeah, trinkets, said the warlock. Yeah, good job, trinket bitch. Added the healer as the group just left. Trinkets? I thought. Trinkets? I mean, there's a vendor on the beta that sells epic trinkets for test purposes. I picked up the ones that Tioras had told me to get. They had, like, some random effects, but they were strength trinkets. I clicked my name on details and discovered that a full 40% of my damage was caused by one trinket. And 18% by another. To say my ego was shattered so quickly would be an understatement. My balls had just shrunk to the size of little peanuts. I wanted to show, though, that Rhett is strong. I didn't want to just blow up dungeons with OP trinkets. It seemed like a waste of time. So, you know what I did? Manned the fuck up, mate. Took off my trinkets. Slapped in some World Quest blues. Queued up again, mate. This time, I was dead bottom of the damage behind the tank. A fresh, pre-made monk in starter gear. I was even below a rogue wearing a Brewfest costume was actually more of an insult. I even started opening the spellbook to see if there was some new Shadowlands Rhett ability that I wasn't pressing. It was awful. I actually felt so small. The dungeon finished just as Tioras came online. I told him what had happened. So use the fucking trinkets then. That's why I told you to get them. But I won't. They're not mine. It's not my damage. What's the point? Whatever, he said. I'll show you all the dungeons. You tank. Did Finn write this? I level as Rhett, but tanking. Tanking. That's my calling. I whipped out my BFA one-hander and shield and accepted the cue. We entered a dungeon that I had never seen yet. It was called the Mists of Turner Scythe. It was gorgeous. A beautiful night fade dungeon. It reminded me of the ever-blooming Wad, but it was even more gorgeous. Fuck me, says Tioras. I ignored him. Just look at the scenery. It was absolutely incredible. I checked out our group. My healer was a dwarf priest who arrived bubbled and almost dead with no mana. The other DPS were a pair of cultier and shamans, one male, one female. Ew. Hi, guys! I said.
Yo, said the priest.
Bonjour, said the female shaman. The male shaman never spoke. Either they were married or multi-boxing, it's impossible to know. Courteously, I wait for the priest to heal up and get some mana. But he never did. Ready to go, priest? I asked in party chat. Tiura's answered by misdirecting me and multi-shotting the trash. Okay, we're going. I pulled smoothly and rapidly up to the first boss. Threat, not a problem. My health was an issue, though. The priest just never got any mana at any point. I blew just about every holy power I could muster to heal myself, but I never died. The shamans were useless, but Tioris is DPS. Hunter DPS. Carrying us big time. Of course, half of it was trinket procs, but that doesn't matter. Things are dying. The first boss, Cake. I know how to manage the disorientating blast that he does on the tank. We knocked it down and moved on to the next interesting area of the Mists of Turnerscythe. Now, if you don't know... the middle section of Mists of Turnerscythe has you chasing a butterfly spirit through a sequence of rooms. The first room has three exits, each with a Dark Souls-style fog door. We entered this first room. Tiaros immediately ran straight into the fog door. And we're teleported somewhere. Now we're in what I believe is a new area. Tiaras once again charges straight into a fog door. And once again we are teleported. But the butterfly spirit is laughing at us. This was all most confusing. Tiaras dashed forward again. What are you doing? I asked as I follow him. ?" says the priest. I don't know. I've never been here before. Says the female shaman. We ran back through two rooms, and the moment Tiaras touched the fog door, teleported again! Just follow me, noobs, I'm teleporting us to the end, says Tiaras. And again we run in, and again we are teleported. I don't think this is right, I said. I think we're at the start. Nearly there now, mate. Easy, next one, says Tiaras. Once again, we follow him, and once again, we're being teleported. Now Tiara stops, and we all stood around, and we can see his characters opening up the map. I definitely know what I'm doing, mate. Just give me a second, mate. Need a drink. It's easy, this. Yeah, I've done this like 12 times. Right piece of piss. We followed him again, and we're teleported. Why are we back at the start? This isn't right. The priest says, what the fuck? What are we doing? We walk back through the second room, and we stop, and we're looking around. The room was empty apart from... This is the only time these guys actually looked at the room. I love this. The room was empty apart from some pillars and foliage. Both the first room and the second room contain the same pillars. All right, guys, get your notepads out. Room 1 has pillars. Room 2 has pillars. There's a pillar by each of the doors. The pillars have glowy flowers and leaf shapes, but you can't click them. This is the one, says Tiaras, still looking at his map. But how do we open it? I'm trying to click the pillar in every direction. I'm looking around it, at the back of it, and then a flower appears atop the pillar. I mouse over the flower, but I can't click it. Perhaps we jump on the pillar, says the shaman. Tiaras and I start jumping up and down the pillars. Maybe we have to jump on the flower ones and sit on the leaf ones. So the shaman and the priest sit near the leaf one. The priest missed and impacted a door. The door opened.
revealing more trash.
What? What wizardry is this? What secrets lurk inside this dungeon?
Well, we did it. We figured it out, I said as we ran into the fight. But then, more fog doors. Which way? I asked.
I could see trash on the other side of this one. Then it must be that one.
How did you open up the other door, priest?
Dunno.
He walked backwards through it, says the shaman. Tierra's turned his character around and backpedaled into the door. Easy, mate. Easy. The butterfly spirit fucking laughed at us. As we are teleported once again to the start of the maze.
Maybe he jumped through, said the shaman.
We ran back and tried it. Same result. Teleported again. You know what? Says the priest. Fuck this. And leaves the group. I queued for a fresh healer as we made our way back to the third room. This isn't even the right way anyway, says Tioras. I think we have to go back through the second room. That's the way I went last time. He leads us back to the second room. And then the most disturbing part of this whole dungeon run. The shaman pipes up. I'll bing it. Like, leave the group immediately, right? No jokes, no memes, just leave. Just get the fuck out of there. Bing it. I'll bing it. Bing! I mouse over every inch of the pillar near Tioras' door, but I can't find anything. Anything useful. Tioras attempted to pull the trash he could see through the door with a trap. He succeeded and the trash came through. But then he touched the wall, assuming it was the right one, and we were teleported again. This place is so buggy, Tioras said. Blizzard need to get their shit together. Lucky they delayed it, by the way, because this is the kind of stuff we don't want happening on live, right, guys? Nothing on Bing, by the way. Just then a druid joins our team. Hey, I said. Hey, do you know how this works? Sure, smile, says the druid, going to stag farm. Thank God, we've been stuck for ages, says the shaman. We all follow the druid. Tioras leapt onto the druid's back and declares, take me the way! The druid took us to the third room and ran right into one of the doors and it opened. And we pulled the trash. How did you do that? I asked. You just walk into him, said the druid. But we've tried that. It doesn't work. Oh, you guys don't know? Only one of the doors works per room. Smile. You look at the grass, is how you figure it out. There is no grass near the correct door. Oh, of course. And then it all hit me. It fell onto me. This is like Zelda. It's like the forest maze. We are now in the fourth fog door. While we fought, I had started inspecting closely the grass by each of the doors. One of them had less grass. As the trash died, I proudly, bravely, ran into that door. I had solved the puzzle of the maze as we were all teleported back to the start. Not that door. Smile, said the druid. He led us back to the fourth room, checked all the doors, and ran right into the same door I had chosen because that's the door that had no grass! As that stupid oo-woo weebo butterfly spirit laughed at us once again. Tioras started swearing, for fuck's sake! The shaman declares, this is so stupid, it's so broken! And the druid says, yeah, it must be broken again. I've had this before where sometimes the grass doesn't work. I'll make a bug report. What a guy. You know what? You guys finish this maze. I'm going AFK, says Tioras. Me too, said the shaman. The other shaman just said nothing as usual, but didn't move when I ran back into the first room. The druid says, nah, I'm out. Can't be bothered with these buggy dungeons. Good luck. Smile. And he quit the group.
20 seconds after our newly found druid had left, the shamans also quit later. Just me and Tiora's left alone in the middle of the maze of Mr. Turner Scythe. I wanted to continue, though, so I just put us back in the queue. Tiora's and I explored the earlier rooms. There must be a clue here somewhere. Some evidence as to what to do. We decided the grass theory held no water. We'll move on. We focused instead on the first room as we knew the correct answer. But how was the answer discovered? I tried to figure out how to open the door straight ahead next to a flower pillar. We tried lighting up other flower pillars at the same time, so maybe if we do multiple flower pillars, that will equal the correct door. We tried taking damage before entering to see if it would knock us through the door. We tried entering two doors at once to fool the system. No joke, at one point we thought it was a Kojima puzzle, and we tried saying flower out loud. I tried bubbling to see if we can immunity the teleport. Nothing worked. Fuck it. Fuck it, said Tioris. I've had enough. It's just not working. Whatever it is, it's not working. As he quit and logged out. Not me, though. I stayed online. I was just trying things at this point. Just testing, seeing what we could figure out. I was determined to learn the secrets of Turner Scythe. The whole group filled up. As it tends to do when you're on your own, the whole group just filled up. These guys just mounted, ran into the maze without a word, and then opened the next two doors without even blinking. The same happened in the next room. How? How are you doing that? I noticed they were all from the same guild. I recognized them as being from Echo. Elitist motherfuckers. Just walking in, just doing the dungeon without a care in the world, was ya? I don't have names, but I know who you are. How? How are you doing that? A mage just replied, question mark. Now, it should be noted, in Mythic Raider terms, this question mark says many things. It says, one, how do you not know? Two, what are you even fucking talking about? Three, can you be more specific? It's many things. The question mark in the Mythic Raid team and the Heroic Raid team, of course, means many, many things. How are you opening the doors, I asked. How? What doors, dude? Said the mage. Will you pull? Said the DK. We smashed the boss and finished the dungeon in no time. The last section is full of knockback mobs who kicked me off an edge a few times, but the rest of the guys didn't seem to have a problem. As the last boss fell, I said, thanks, guys, as we all looted. I have to ask again, though. In that maze bit, how? How did you do it? How did you work it out? LOL! Said the mage in all caps. You can't match shapes, mate! Just match the shapes on the poles, said the mage. Just walk through the door that's the different one. It can't be that easy. Surely I would have noticed that the pictures above the pillars were different. Surely someone in our previous group would have noticed. I ran back. I felt like the biggest fucking idiot ever once I realized that, yep, there was an odd one out. God damn it. As a warning to your community, and to anybody who's about to play the Shadowlands, it's not bugged, it's nothing to do with grass, you don't need to stand on multiple pillars, just find the odd one out, and you shall be saved. Thank you for reading my little story, and it is that easy once you get in there. Can confirm though, Mr. Turner Scythe is bugged on many, many occasions, so it does bug out on occasion, but you know. Magic shapes, we all know, it's such a facepalm. It's nothing worse than when all these dudes turn up and start wrecking the place. That does bring us to the end of drama time for this week, but we should be around tomorrow. We're either going to have a Resident Evil movie watch night, because they're all on Prime, and that sounds kind of fun. We might be checking out the new Pokemon DLC. Something relaxing for the weekend after so much WoW this week. I thank you very much for being here with us today. You guys have been awesome all week. I'm putting up with these constant internet issues. I truly apologize. There's nothing I can actually do about it. But we dropped 82,458 frames throughout that. So any of you who still remained throughout drama time, I truly appreciate it. Thank you very, very, very much. I am going to love you and leave you. Rest, not at the moment. We have things to do. I have a meeting in 5 minutes. So no, I have a meeting in 5 minutes. Let's send you guys over to Mr. JB, who is joining us on the EU servers. He is joining us on the EU servers. He is coming home to where the big boys play, size limit. Come on, USA. Get your goddamn shit together. Even if you're not sticking around, give him a hell's yeah. Give him a hell's yeah from us. I will see you very, very soon. All right, guys? I will see you very, very soon. Please be good. And stay safe. Yes, have a good weekend. Lockdown is initiating, at least here, in the next little while. Be good, and I'll see you later. Bye-bye.